embarrassed about this. But I'm not embarrassed for me, I'm embarrassed for you. Because I need to go to this length to show you how ridiculous the idea that you live on a spinning ball actually is. Me standing in the pissing rain, getting soaking wet, you make the point. Hope you appreciate this. Hey, found this shape. I've seen it in other videos of the ball earth with the oceans removed. Okay? So let's try this. I don't know what's happening, but it doesn't appear to be filling up to the shape of the ball. It seems to be running off the bottom here. I'll try this. Again, it's running off the sides. I can't get it to be mound up to the shape of the board. I don't know why. Should I spin it? Should I spin it?
Aye.
Give it a spin. How about you? Right, let's see. Oh. It appears that the water seems to be running off the side, finding its own level again, but we'll give something else a try, yeah? Should we go for this? Should we go for this here? That there seems to be more level on this side here. I'm thinking maybe gravity prefers this side to this side, or maybe it's just because it's on uneven ground. We'll try this, see what happens. Oh, 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 and now you can see that it tilts out, finds its own level. What about this here? Some objects here. Different things. Don't know if you can see this here, but these objects here seem to have fell out with gravity, or gravity doesn't like them, because they seem to be floating. Now, is it either gravity doesn't like these objects, or is it because maybe these objects are less dense, so they float? Just an idea, you know. So we'll try something else. How about this? It would appear that it's running off here, finding its own level and spilling away again. What can I say? I don't know what else to say to you about that. But do you really think that this is the ocean here, and if I take the side away, that the water will stay? Or on the ball here, you know, you really think that the oceans are like this, you know, and upside down with it, it's like this, and wee boats can run here and hang upside down in the water, that all just sticks to that? I mean, does it get any more ridiculous than that? Does there need to be any other argument? No. If you want to find out where we live, how does water behave? Finds its own level. Therefore, the earth is flat. Simple. Okay? I don't know if you can see this up here as well. We've got these things called gutters on the top of the houses. Okay? So that when the rainwater runs off the top of the houses, it goes into these gutters and it finds its way to a point where it drains away. I don't know why it doesn't just mound up on top of the gutters, or mounds up on top of the roof. You know? That's it. There's no argument. The earth's flat.
Here's the beastie they're going to have to come and argue with. Yes, he don't need to beat you into. Big nose in the lens, man. and I'll let people know if they might try and come at night. I tie an elastic band around his buzz, so he's always on edge.
Keep him up tight.
Aye. MD goes through Glasgow and he hears them. Big vicious, look at that big vicious beast. Keating it.
You started?
Aye, been videoing my back door and everything.
Right.
But you can edit that, all that stuff out.
I know. Right, this is to address the last video. Loads of ridiculous comments coming. I know that it's in the back door and that I'm showing it on a football and other bits and bobs, but the point's valid. The physics of water is undeniable. It doesn't lie. Can't escape that. Enough of this fucking nonsense. Doesn't matter if the football's a million miles in diameter or 30,000 miles in circumference, the physics of water is still going to be the same. It's a ridiculous argument. If you believe that water can conform to the external at any shape, bring it forward and show me it. Until then, shut up. Right? It's a fact of life. The physics of water are undeniable. End of story. I don't even know why I have to keep repeating it.
I mean, do your scientists themselves, do they not just like use water as a level or greater distances or whatever?
Of course. When you even go to your Wikipedia and it'll tell you a water levelling device and it'll tell you over great distances it's more accurate than lasers. Because that's just the nature of water. Undeniable. Now to say to me that I'm standing here on the beach looking out to supposedly the ship disappearing over the curvature of the earth. Now what you're trying to tell me is that for this point that I stand at, the ocean is curving away from me, but the water's not flowing. How do you explain that? I mean, it's ridiculous. It's fucking retarded.
I mean, what size does it actually start curving at,
exactly,
according to these globalists?
I know. Give me the figures. You tell me how large the body of water needs to be before it will display curvature. I don't even know why I'm saying that, because it's not going to happen. I mean, it's nonsense.
No, but you're saying the globalists, that's something they can try so that they can come back and say, well, there you go, there's a model.
Exactly. You know, but the onus is on me to somehow prove. I mean, how does that work? The claim that I was born into, the claim that yous were born into, is that you live on a globe. Now, where is the evidence of that? But the other thing that's really pissing me off and what I'm seeing all the time is these red herring arguments. Look at the sky. Look at the moon. Look at the stars. How can the sun do this? How can the sun do that? I don't give a fuck. I don't care. How can looking at the sky ever prove to me the shape of the ground that I'm standing on? It's not on. It's ridiculous. I mean, what else can I add to that? You know what I mean? There's nothing else to say.
Nah, as you say, the rest of it's all red herrings. It doesn't match the stars. Well, how do they know if that apparently the stars are moving or whether this fucking place we live on is moving?
Well,
you know?
We know that. We'll get the experiments, the Aries failure, and the Meekos and Morley experiments.
Do you know Aristoteles or something as well?
All that stuff is meaningless to me. I'm just a guy. He's just a guy. You're just normal people. I mean, how do we decide where we are? For me, I can observe, I can test repeatedly. Everybody alive can test and repeat water. Nobody's ever going to come back and say, oh, by the way, I found water that can conform to the external of shapes and that I can have one side higher or at a lower elevation than the other and the water's not going to flow. I mean, it's just nonsense. Gear up. The globe is a childish cartoon. It's all you have. Cartoons. Images. Stars. The moon. The sun. Who gives a fuck? It's not going to answer the question of what shape it is that we live in. For me personally, it has to be able to contain the water. It has to contain the oceans. So there's your starter. You know, external shapes, squares, triangles, forget it. It has to be the inside of any shape. You know, we could be inside a sphere, you know, concave reality, flat earth reality, and hollow earth reality. Could amalgamate them all. We could get the truth by combining a lot of them. I'm starting to look at it and that's exactly what's going on.
Why are they trying, I mean, especially all these globalists as such, to call them as that, are all going on about, oh, fuck, they're all wanting everybody to pick a map.
Exactly.
You know, what is that all about? Because nobody's actually got a map.
No, there's no model that works. And this is what I'm seeing by the trolls, we'll call them the trolls, on Facebook, Jay Summers, people like that, you know who you are. desperate to get you to defend a model. How can I defend a model? I would have to invest in belief and faith. I don't know what the whole dimensions are, where everything is on Earth, or what the outer shape is. Nobody does. Well, some people do, but we don't. So, what I see is this push for these models, and all the prominent flat earthers are pushing them, and I don't know why, because they need to be realistic and start being honest with themselves.
Especially if they're wanting to use any kind of science, they can't just come out with a hypothetical thing if they can't prove it themselves.
No, I mean, they need empirical observations. No, none of this. Yesterday was the same.
Oops. Just went off. Oh, it's no. That was just the screen went off. You're all right, mate.
Yesterday was the same. We have these experiments in the lab that prove the Earth's a globe. I mean, how the fuck do you take an experiment into the lab to prove the Earth's a globe?
Only if we live in a lab.
Exactly.
So what they're trying to do is a macro to the micro.
But it shouldn't be that difficult to recreate.
No.
You know, anything that you claim is true, you know, if you can't model that, if you tell me you live in a globe and I say, fair do. If I was meeting you for the first time, never knew anything about any indoctrination or any beliefs, nothing being pushed to me, and you came to me and says, we live in a globe. First thing I'm going to say to you is, fair dues, can you show me? How are you going to show me that you live in a globe? I'm still waiting for this one empirical proof that you live on a globe, that the surface, the ground that you stand upon is indeed a globe. Where is it? Don't keep bringing the stars, the sun, the moon. Not interested. Not at all. I'm trying to think of what else I need to say about this. You know, do I need to keep bringing the hose out and filling stuff with water to show you? I mean, you can all do it. Go and try it. If anybody can bring me water conforming to the exterior at any shape, or slopes without the water flowing, all these things that deny, spit in the face of natural science.
Mm-hmm.
Until then, shut up. The globe's just a childish cartoon. It's time for the light to come out. And anybody that's defending it now, if it's no through, I'll give you the first time through ignorance. After that, you're now a criminal, actively pushing a religion, as far as I'm concerned. And it needs to stop. It's child abuse, brainwashing kids, robbing them of their grounding. I mean, how are we ever going to figure anything out when we don't even know where we are? You know, it's like a blindfold. If you believe you live in a globe, and you're invested in that belief, then everything that comes after that in your life is a total fabrication, a total lie. You're never going to make sense of anything. No wonder people are jumping to religion, new age spirituality, and all these fucking nonsense things. Stop it, okay? Wake up. Start being honest with yourself. We don't know who we are. We don't know where we are. It's as simple as that. The globe, childish nonsense. So where are we? We know it needs to contain the oceans. That's as far as I know.
I mean, how far does the globe theory go? Basically, haphazard accidents floating through an infinite nothingness that fucking hundreds of thousands of miles an hour spiralling after a giant ball of fire.
It's all that. It's all this stuff where we know science and all the stuff that we use, we can apply stuff, we need to see it, we need to observe it, we need to be able to test it repeatedly. But all of a sudden when it comes to this, oh, it's 15 billion years ago. And far, far, far away.
In a galaxy far, far away.
Magic nothing created everything. Get fucked. We don't observe that either. We don't observe something from nothing. Ridiculous. And this whole thing about layers of gas getting up to a vacuum. I mean, can we recreate that? Have you ever been able to experience that? Can you recreate a vacuum without a solid barrier in between?
Oh, you know yourself, my trade was air conditioning, so we had to vac out every system.
Of course.
And we couldn't do it with even the slightest hairline fracture on a weld.
Why?
Because it would equilibrate.
Equilibrate. That's the thing. That's what we observe. That's what we test. That's what we know. The same as the physics of water. We use it. We've used it in construction for centuries. Are you going to go away and tell all these builders to put their tools down because, by the way, the buildings are wonky? Nothing's level because water can conform to spheres. Ridiculous, man. So, all this fucking nonsense that we can't test, we can't observe, and we can't repeat, it has to go. Right? And I'm sorry I'm swearing all the time, but I can't help it. I'm fucking tired.
People are arguing about hypothetical nonsense.
Yes, you go into Facebook and you get the same shite over and over and
copy
over.
Copy and paste, copy and paste.
The first thing I'm asking you for is model it. Show me. If you claim that something's reality, then you should be able to recreate it. It's as simple as that. No, if you can't do that, it's fucking nonsense. Mm-hmm. And I've heard the Jay Summers or these trolls, whatever, I've said, well, if they can't model the globe, it's not real, but I don't defend any model of flat earth, so therefore flat earth isn't real. No, I'm not saying any of the models are correct. What I'm saying is that whatever it is, it has to be able to contain the oceans. So to me, yes, the surface is flat, okay? We've got high bits, low bits, but we judge all that by sea level. You can't have sea level on a globe. It's retarded. They're not even talking about trying to express anything. The globe is just so infuriating that it's time for it to go.
But a lot of folk are obviously going to have what there's known as your cognitive dissonance, because it's an accepted belief when they were 2 year old.
That's it.
You know, that's what they need to get past.
When I was 2 year old, I accepted Santa Claus.
Yeah.
Does that mean because I accepted it and everybody else accepted it, all the kids at that time, that made it real?
Mm.
Of course not.
It made it real in their own imagination.
That's what the globe is. Deceitful imagination.
Mm-hmm.
You've got to take your hat after them, you know?
Oh, they're fucking clever.
Aye.
Too fucking clever.
So what are we seeing now, this desperate attempt to cover it up? Is that what you really think's going on? Because I don't think they're trying to cover it up anymore.
Oh, fuck, you've seen the NASA videos lately, they're not covering up fuck all.
So what's the plan? They're just going to relinquish this control? No chance.
No.
You know, why are these people here? Why are these prominent flat earth people in the positions they're in pushing models that are unproven? That's a charlatan to me. I don't care who you are.
Mm-hmm.
If you're pushing anything other than realism, we don't know where we are. Don't act like a guru that you know something that all the other people don't. You're just causing more confusion.
Mm-hmm.
Be realistic, be honest. People need to start being honest with themselves. If you keep pushing these models, you're going to see what's happening continuously. They're coming in and demanding that you answer these questions today with this model or that model, when you can't answer that. How are we going to
And repeating shite for books isn't the answer?
No. Citing stuff. I don't want to read fucking never-ending paragraphs or papers for so-called scientists or anything like that. Fuck off. Just show me it.
Mm.
You know? You claim you live on a sphere, globe, pear, whatever the fuck you want to call it, bring the model forward. Bring any scientist forward to me, Brian Cox or fucking Neil deGrasse Tyson, anybody you want, anybody who's going to stand in front of me and deny the physics of water. That's proper science deniers. And don't keep saying science. You better start telling people what science you're referring to.
Aye.
You know? Natural science, formal science, or social science, because there's a huge fucking difference. I'm sure there's mathematical formulas and equations that can say that if I flap my ears fast enough, I'll be able to fly up to the top of that roof. Is it reality? Of course it's no fucking reality. Enough with the pseudoscience.
Yep. Back to natural.
The stuff on Facebook, they're there, it's a psychological operation. They're trying to get at you emotionally. They hope that you're emotionally attached to the screen. You can see it, it's so simple to watch. And people will have seen me getting involved, but I'm not there emotionally trying to think that I'm going to convince these trolls or these agents, whatever they are, that the globe's a lie. I'm there to take the piss out of them. That's what I'm there to do. Take the piss out of them, show them up, and hope that real, genuine people will recognise that when they're reading the comments.
Because the latest one, or not the latest one, the usual instant MO, as soon as somebody looks at something new, you've got other shills, trolls, to use their labels as such, they just go in and vitriolically attack them.
Yeah.
You know? And they're like, oh, well, I'm not going to look at that again. And that's their whole purpose. You know?
I know.
If people can get past that and just say, well, he knows fuck all, so fuck him.
Yeah.
They're only another fucking binary in another end of a fucking line somewhere.
That's it. Yeah. And expecting you to have beliefs to defend.
Oh, wow.
I'm never going to accept any belief. I don't do beliefs, I only want to find out the truth. So if I don't know something, I'm not just going to make something up in my mind to satisfy myself for that moment in time. No, I'll keep pursuing until I find that. And that's what I encourage you to do as well. You know, if you keep pushing beliefs, stuff that's unproven, you're going to cause problems. It's holding everything back. It's got to go. What else can I add to that? If you deny my last video, sarcasm, there's nothing I can do about sarcasm. I displayed the sarcasm because it's fucking ridiculous. No, it wasn't that I was being sarcastic at myself and taking the piss out myself. No, I'm taking the piss out of people who deny the physics of water. No, people who believe that the ship went over the horizon or over the curvature of the air, you know?
Did they gather speed as it fell air?
Rivers would just all be stuck to the sides of mountains. Ooh. Nothing flowing. What a weird world that would be.
Fucked. Can't be any fucking weirder than the shit we're living in now.
Nothing would work. It's just fucking crap.
Nah.
What else do you add, I mean? The celebrities are just stringing it out. You know, they're making it to be a debate. The globe earth versus the flat earth debate. There isn't a debate.
Back to the duality.
Yeah. Debates are for ideas. Debates are for when you don't know. When I make something that I think is true and you make something and then we debate it and we argue and we emotionally appeal to people and blah, blah, blah. You know, it's like we can both observe that there's a brick there. Right? We know the brick is there. So I can then go, well, I think that brick got there because of such and such, and he'll say that got there because of such and such, and that's where the debate will come. But the fact of the matter is the brick is there.
There's quite a lot of them, actually.
Eh?
There's quite a lot of them.
So, debate. You want to debate your religions? Debate your religions. Mm-hmm. I'm not interested, I'm interested in science. Pure natural science. Empirical observations. Show me. Mm. Prove it. You know?
Exactly.
Anything you came to me with and says, made a claim about reality and I asked you to show me or prove it or model it and you couldn't produce that, you'd just be laughed at.
Right.
Ignored instantly.
I mean, here's the thing, right? Obviously the money and everything that NASA's getting thrown at them and they've got this big ISS thing apparently floating around. Right? And now every now and again they'll take a wee picture. Right? Now, how do they just fucking attach a camera on the outside of it all the time?
But that's just that, you know,
to me that's logic. Right. And then there you go. There's, so to speak,
well,
proof.
I've heard other people saying, Matt Powell was the last one I heard talking about that, you know, saying it would be at the forefront of the expectation, all that money, all that investment, you know, oh, we're travelling to outer space, you know, you'd think it would be the priority to get full HD,
mm-hmm.
full spins of the air, the weather patterns, monitoring everything that's happening, you know.
But they didn't have HD in the 60s. But they fucking did.
I was a mechanic in the late 80s, start of the 90s. I know how shit engines were and how advanced the technology was. You're no fucking telling me that they jumped in a firework in the 1960s and went 238,000 miles away. Get fucked. As I say, can I get off subject, but I mean, I think it's all relevant, you know. Stop idolising. Stop following these people. Stop giving these gurus a place to push maps and all these ideals and beliefs, because it's just going to get us in their shit. No, strip them. Don't appease them, because you.
I mean,
like
even
them.
The flat earthers, if they turn around and promote a map, tell them to prove it.
Exactly.
Prove the
any
fucking
flat,
map.
Somebody that's claiming it's flat, that's pushing a map or pushing any ideas, I'm going to strip that apart as much as I'm going to strip the globe apart. I'm just honest with myself.
Because right. That's what the end game of the shills and trolls are. Where's the ice walls?
Exactly.
Who says there's ice walls?
That's a great point, because that's what I'm seeing when I'm getting into these Facebook pages mm-hmm. of flat earth.
Who's promoting ice walls?
Straight away when you put something up, show us the edge, show us a full picture, show us, where are you getting these ideas from?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
If that's, you get a preconception of what flat means, that's your problem. That's another belief that you need to work out, you know? Ridiculous.
Why?
So I don't really know what else to add to that. I'm just sick of the saga, I'm sick of the fucking celebrityism and let's string it out into some sort of fucking debate. You know, it's natural science isn't about debate.
Nah. You know, but as you know yourself, it's getting flooded to the point of dilution, which yep. is where all the information's actually getting lost and people exactly. are just copying and pasting some wee sound bites again.
Exactly.
It's like any religion, if you've got a lovely wee sound bite, you just repeat.
Yeah.
But all they're doing is pacifying their own insecurities. Yeah. They don't actually realise they're saying nothing of substance.
No,
you know? But in their heads, they are.
I know.
Delusional fuckwits.
You can see anything of substance, but until you bring it to me and show me it, it's just words.
Mm-hmm.
And I copy and paste, but I copy and paste stuff that I've done before. Today with natural science and trying to help people out to figure out what's actually happening, and I can't be bothered typing the same thing out again, so I'll copy it and I'll paste it. But it's not because it's a belief or an opinion, it's facts or reality. It's stuff we use, engineering.
Well, you were saying that there, sorry to interject, but the other thing is you'll quote references.
Yeah.
Right. Now, there's a lot of folk out there that are just copying and pasting other folks' ideas and putting them across as their own. You know, that's not right. If you're going to quote somebody, at least fucking reference them.
Exactly.
Rather than sitting there like you're fucking, oh, look at me, I'm all big and I'm on my wee IKEA pedestal.
The gurus.
Aye.
Think they're going to lead us forth and they're going to be worshipped as some sort of god. Fuck off, I'm never going to worship anybody.
No.
I don't give a shit who you are. I don't want to be anybody's pal. I don't give a fuck about any of that. I want the truth out. When I was a kid, I knew something was fucked with this place. And that question has never let go. I knew it, I found it. And I'm not going to let go. I'm not going to accept any pish that comes through a screen or that anybody tells me, any appeals to authority or nothing. You better fucking show me.
Mm-hmm.
If you can't do that, you're a liar.
The only thing that can change you is actual tangible evidence.
Mm-hmm. That's who I am. Open, questioning, always. Removing beliefs, always questioning whether it's something I hope to be true, that I believe to be true, that I wish to be true. You eradicate all that kind of stuff. Still recording?
Aye.
What other points? I mean, I don't want to make this video a long-winded
rant.
Probably half the people aren't going to understand the Scottish stuff anyway.
We'll do a transcript into proper English.
Just let me know and I'll put some words on the screen and you can get what I'm saying. But don't let these trolls intimidate you. Don't let them get to you emotionally. It's a fucking computer screen. Remove your emotions. Stick to the facts. Don't get involved.
And that goes for globalists and flat earth as well. Everybody.
Of course.
Don't just believe what somebody else says. Exactly. You know, you need to be able to reproduce it yourself.
Of course.
If you can't reproduce it yourself, you're just repeating hearsay, so you're just a wee automaton.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You're no changing in any way, shape or form. You'll just jump from one religion to another religion like some folk do and just preaching that one.
Exactly.
You know?
And that's what's happened. They've been handed this new model and everybody's jumped on it. And it was deliberate because it creates an idea of a debate.
Mm-hmm.
Because you've got one model that's total fucking bollocks and you've got one that's kind of true. With bollocks.
Mm-hmm.
So all they're going to do
kind of possible as opposed to true.
Aye. And they'll just pick on the bollocks to make you look daft.
Aye.
And
that's why they want everybody to attach themselves to something.
Exactly.
And what they want you attached to is what they're throwing out for you to attach yourself to.
Exactly.
So they can go like that. See, they've attached to that disc pizza shaped thing. Whew, just took that away for them because we've just proved it is shite.
Because what they've done is it's a huge revelation. You know, you find out where you've been your whole life is a lie.
Mm.
So in that emotional state, the cognitive dissonance and all the turmoil that's going on inside you, yeah, they offer you that and you go, whoa! Because it feels good to let go of that whole nonsense, big bang accident fucking crap. So you cling on to that, thinking, oh, well, this is the truth because it's been presented to you. It's no, as I said at the start, I'm not going to relinquish control that easily.
And just because somebody talks nice doesn't mean to say you've got to follow them.
Exactly.
You listen and see if you can reproduce it yourself and then say, oh, well, that actually works.
That's it. Don't listen to the messenger. Don't listen to me. I'm a tattooed, angry, looking, big, fucking, angry sounding guy. But it doesn't matter. I'm still full of love. You know, it's doesn't mean I'm a mass murderer or going out to harm people or anything like that. And it's the same with everybody else, you know. You're the most sweet, innocent person there telling you the same thing, but they're a psychopath.
Mm-hmm.
Enough of this fucking labelling and trying to pigeonhole everybody and dissect it and split everybody up. Fuck it.
Mm-hmm.
No. Where's the rebels? Where's the anarchists? Huh?
See, this is the thing as well. There's no such thing as rebels because everybody's looking for a leader. There's nobody actually there that's doing things for themselves. They're following other folk, listening to other folk. You know? And even at the same point, I mean, it's people that are actually speaking the truth don't want to be followed anyway.
No.
They're not saying, oh, follow me.
No.
The folk that are saying, listen to me, and follow me, and don't question what I say, they're the ones that people should be watching out for.
Aye.
You know?
Yeah.
Listen to nobody.
Exactly. Come on, people. They're publishing books. They're getting on national television. It's getting everywhere. If they really wanted this hushed, then it would be hushed.
Aye.
But it's not being hushed. So you need to be suspect of what's been offered.
Aye.
You know, it's as simple.
I mean, if they're gullible enough to believe that mainstream is actually, no, what's the word, objective. there's never been a mere biased thing in the world.
All that people knew are catcalling on the fact that mainstream politicians, all these leaders are awful of crap. They're all lying to you. They always have been lying to you. All we have is fake images for space. Loads of fucking crap. But Oh no, 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 they would never be lying about that. They could never lie that there's a nature-defying sphere pair.
Sphere pair?
It's nature-defying! You know what I mean? Do you science, bro? Fuck me, man. You know what science was if it jumped up and bit you in the arse? You bring Neil deGrasse Tyson to me, Brian Coxless, any of these fucking numpties. Bring him in front of me, Brian Cox, come and see me. I want you to stand in front of me and defend your fucking globe.
Mm-hmm.
Better bring the best proof you've got.
Especially when he was standing beside an American astronaut that was saying the whole purpose of the International Space Station is so that they can progress to actually eventually reaching the moon.
I know.
Now that was stated right to Brian Cox's face, along with Dara O'Brien, that Irish comedian. Not one of them questioned it. Just overlook, no.
We're just fuck nozzles.
But the whole point of dissing NASA is because they're the ones that everybody's getting their information from. They're the CGI'd images that everybody's looking at. They're the cartoons that everybody's watching.
Yeah.
You know, that's why NASA is needing to be totally dissed.
Aye.
You know, people need to look at it and say, well, hang on the new. NASA's saying this. Well, how come they're saying that they want to eventually reach the moon, but they're promoting that they went to the moon in the fucking late 60s?
Right.
You know?
Oh, but now they're starting to say, oh, well, we know that was, everybody knows that was fake, but the one in the 70s was real. Fuck off.
Changing the script and everybody will still follow.
I know.
People need to stop following the script.
Yeah.
You know? And to me, I take it down to the proverbial, if you know somebody's a liar and a fucking arsehole, would you vote for them?
Yeah.
Because everybody still votes. Yeah.
Why are we voting for people?
Where do they think they're getting led?
I know.
Let's all vote for a leader.
Mm-hmm. I saw this whole attitude of...
But this is all part of the agenda.
Aye.
Because through their Big Bang theory, their globe theory, that we're accidents spinning around in a fucking empty void for billions of years, we're made to feel insignificant.
Of course, that's a psychological effect.
Aye. So when you feel insignificant, you're going to end up living in fear. And when you're in fear and in that sort of frame of mind, they're just going to control you.
Exactly.
You know, come to me, I'll help you. Come to me, I'll help you.
Baffling you with nonsense.
You can edit all that shite, but...
No, I'm not going to edit any. That's the other thing. I'm not going to come across as a professional filmmaker or sit here and try and present like I'm expecting a career in fucking...
I know, we're just a shirt and tie, for fuck's sake.
I know. Fuck all that. And all these people that are trying to make it look professional. I couldn't give a shit. I don't want this, all this celebrity stuff transferred onto the whatever's going to happen in the new world or whatever. I don't want all that shit. I don't know what else to say. Can we just summarise what we've been over? I mean, I don't know.
Basically, if you want to promote a globe, you need to remodel it showing water on a curve.
Yeah.
Simple as that.
Use all the elements that make up this globe and shows it.
I mean, even if you want to try and put hundreds of iron filings through water and try and get it to stick to a magnet, guarantee you, the water will still fall fucking half level, flat, but the iron filings might just stay on the magnet.
And showing us a blob of water in some contrived, controlled environment isn't it a natural representation. It's not a representation of reality. Okay?
No.
It's in a lab. It's controlled and made. It's fucking nonsense. Oh, look at my blob of water on the bit of string. Fucking... Or my wee bat with my bit of water. I mean, fuck off.
Here's an
good here.
See all the blobs of water that they've apparently got in the ISS? How's it no damaged all their fucking machinery?
I know.
You know, that's a seriously highly electronic fucking bit of kit, apparently.
People have touched on that.
No. But
it's
anyway.
It's fucking nonsense anyway.
I know.
You know what I mean? I'm tired of the kiddie shit in the same fucking argument.
But to the same extent, there's a lot of folk just coming into this who earn the, so to speak, that far down the road. You know, so it's nice to let them know as well, listen, things to watch out for.
Yeah, that's what I'm trying to say, the new people coming in and trying to educate them properly and what we're actually trying to achieve and what we're trying to prove. The argument is the Earth that we're on a sphere or is it flat? The people have their own preconceptions of what flat means. You need to ask people what they mean by flat.
As soon as you mention flat Earth to anybody, the first thing that's through their head is pizza.
A pizza
with an ice wall. Aye. That's what people see. So where did that image come from? Where did that get promoted?
It's another belief.
It's mere subliminal.
Of course it is.
You know, so if they fall off of one, they're falling onto another.
And you know that because they're automatically asking you the questions as if that's the model you're there to represent.
Aye.
I never ever claimed I was representing any model. I represent the fucking truth.
Mm-hmm. Yeah? The truth as it stands, no theorisations, no fucking hearsay.
No.
No bullshit, just actual fucking tangible proof? Is that too much to ask for?
No.
I mean, apparently they went to the moon, what was that, Earth, 50 years ago? And they're still getting any fucking proof.
I know.
So, in 50 years, look how far technology has advanced, right?
Yeah.
So, do you not think they'd be fucking busloads to the moon band back by now?
Of course.
You know, when they invented the first fucking train, how long did it take them to railroad America? You know, but that, I'm just using that as a sort of analogy.
It's 60 years, been over 60, nearly 60 years now, since they supposedly went the first time to the moon. Where's the high definition footage? Where's the 24/7?
I think it was no 69 they went to the moon, so that would be roughly about 47, 37 years ago.
Aye.
No, I'm trying to think. I can't, couldn't, I've lost my... See?
Does it matter when it was?
Aye. Oh, but
decades ago, we should have advanced way beyond that.
47.
You know. I don't want to keep this video going on too long because I know that people lose their attention span.
Just leave it at that then, if you can think of anything else, just add a wee... Was that an epilogue at the end?
Just a summary, because I'm not going to try and edit everything and make it professional.
No, I didn't mean edit. If you think you've missed out anything,
aye,
you can do a wee epilogue video.
I'll make another video.
Aye.
You know, if people are listening, then I'll make another video. So, being honest, I know the globe is a lie. There's absolutely no evidence for a globe. If you have any evidence, and by evidence I don't mean red herring arguments, looking at the sky, sun, the moon, any of that fucking nonsense. The best proof you've got that you live on a globe, bring it forward. And you've no go at it. Stop telling fucking lies, okay? Can you model it? So where are we? Has to contain the oceans. That's the only place I'm at. All the rest of it's whatever. People need to start getting pissed off.
As you're saying there about containing the oceans, but the same goes for the atmosphere.
Exactly.
Because you can't have pressure beside a vacuum.
No.
You know, in no way, shape or form.
But that's a good point, because that leads me on to this whole question of, is it a sealed unit that we're in, or is it an infinite plane? Because for me, if it's an infinite plane, then how do you keep the pressure and how do you stop the air and everything from equilibrating sideways? You know, at some point...
It has to be a fully contained system.
It has to be a fully contained system.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe with inlets and outlets. I mean, who knows? I played with the idea that we're maybe in something like a gyroscope.
Mm-hmm.
You know, as I said at the start, you know, concave Earth, globe Earth and flat Earth. The whole lot of them, combine them together, that could be the reality we're in.
Mm.
We're on the flat surface, inside...
No, you just done the other now.
What?
See if you look at Harry Potter movies.
Aye.
They've got a big... And one, I'm not right into Harry Potter as such, but I watched it with the Waynes. And I noticed ones... There was like a flat plane in one of their labs or something inside a big glass ball.
Yeah.
But it was also had like the elephants going in it, no carrying the moon and the sun. But back to Verdict, is it?
Verdict.
You know? But even as I say, that things like that are on the telly as such. So people want to say, oh, I seen it on the telly. Well, there you go, watch Harry fucking Potter. He tells you live in a flat plane inside a big glass ball.
But to me, that's stuff that we can theorise on and we can play with.
Aye.
We can't prove any of that stuff just now.
But until somebody can prove that you can put a vacuum beside pressure,
yep,
until somebody can prove that you can form water into shapes,
yeah, the external
issues. There's natural science that we can all observe, so yep, until anybody can change that, then theoretically that, to a certain extent, proves that we're within a contained system.
Well, go to be.
Mm-hmm.
There's no other way around about that.
Because, I mean, there's another thing I was wanting to say to globalists as well. What model do they actually follow?
Aye.
You know, do they look at the solar system the way it's put across, like a two-dimensional line? You've got the sun, then Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, then you've got the big asteroid belt,
that's
or whatever.
The they show you it, isn't it? They show you it two-dimensional.
They show you it two-dimensional.
Yeah.
But the actuality of their science is that the sun is fucking round its own orbit at hundreds of thousand miles an hour.
Yeah.
And all of these planets within the solar system are actually spiralling round it in almost like a tail shape,
yeah,
following it.
Yeah.
So how do they get the two-dimensional? And then suddenly, when in reality they tell you the science is three-dimensional, or actually four-dimensional, with all the other planets spiralling,
yep,
in a sort of ever-decreasing, perpetual spiral following the sun.
Yeah.
You mean, that's the kind of things I'm just like, really?
Aye.
So what globe model are you following? The two-dimensional linear solar system?
Yeah.
Or the spiralling,
yep,
solar system?
These so-called critical thinkers that still believe in the globe, they want to apply this critical thought to the globe.
Mm-hmm.
Because you're a moron if you say you're a critical thinking truth seeker and come back to me and say, oh, I still believe we live in a globe, we need proof.
Right.
No evidence whatsoever. I mean, it's over 6 months now, and I've continually asked for the best evidence that any of these globe pushers have got that they live on a globe. Mm. And all I ever get, the stars, the sun and the moon. You know? Oh, the flat earth model can't work because the sun sets and blah blah blah.
That means like planes must rise and set.
Aye.
You know, as they, as you see them going past you in the sky.
People think the plane at the same altitude, it's at 35,000 feet, way in the distance. It looks to you as if it's low. As it comes towards you, you think it's doing an arc over the top of you because of your perspective.
Bollocks. Much the same as the sun.
Things doing a straight line, keeping the same altitude. It's just how your perspective works.
Exactly.
So, anyway, looking up there is never going to solve what you're standing on.
Correct.
Right? Red herrings, get them to fuck. No more, and don't accept it. Just cut people off right away when they start that shit.
Aye.
Get it out of the argument.
As soon as they make one assumption, you know.
Aye.
Well, the sun's 93 million miles away. Prove it. You got 93 million mile fucking tape measure.
93 million miles.
It's just big numbers to bamboozle people.
Baffle
you. Aye. So you may feel even more insignificant.
So far, 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 far away and blah, blah, blah.
But that's how these scientists are on their own pedestals. Aye. Because they can deal with the big numbers, you know.
Super big brains that can...
It's like the old Tefal adverts for the haze.
I know.
Tefal napples.
Stewie for Family Guy.
Coneheads.
I know.
Oh, what was that wee snippet of Coneheads? Something about, have you ever seen the movie Coneheads?
Aye.
The two of them were sitting across from the table. It. People use it as a meme a lot.
Right.
I think it's a line, they went, man, went to the moon. Ha!
<I know.
laughs>
Oh,
dear.
Running before you can walk.
Mm-hmm.
So, anyway. There's nothing else I can really add to that, you know.
Back
on. I'm not going to edit this.
No.
I'm not going to edit it. No. Why? What's the fucking point?
Because some bits are just nonsense and it's just rabbiting.
The Globe's nonsense. I've been listening to fucking nonsense for 38 years. So people can put up with a couple of minutes of nonsense in this video. Please stop pushing models. Just pull yourself back. You're in, under the obligation to put forth a model or defend any model. Because you can falsify something doesn't mean to say you need something else to put in its place. They came to us with a claim, they pushed that one to us. Now we're rejecting it.
Another thing about pushing models as well is you can actually note them there because they barely big stilettos.
We've been lied to. We need the numbers a week. We need everybody aware of this lie without investing in anything fake. Then the next thing we need to demand is full disclosure. If we're no forthcoming with full disclosure, we need full exploration. Or else we're just going to keep running in circles, no knowing whether what we're being told or what Andy's shown us is really true.
Aye, that's been covered then, just
caught
quits at that. Aye. Last thing, by the way, switch off your tellies. One